Hello everyone, I am Mary Swanatha, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss the topics autocorrelation and the properties of autocorrelation. So what is correlation? So already in the previous lecture, we have seen the concept of correlation. Correlation is nothing but measuring the similarity between two quantities. And similarly, if we are having two random variables, x1 and x2, then the correlation between these two random variables has been represented by R x1 x2 is equals to expectation of x1 into x2. So this is called as the correlation between two random variables x1 and x2. So correlation is nothing but measuring the similarity. And what I have taken here, I have taken two random variables. Therefore, what is Rx1, x2 represents? It represents the measuring the similarity between two random variables x1 and x2. Nothing but what? Correlation of those two random variables x1 and x2. Now, if the random variables x1 and x2 are continuous random variables, then how do you calculate the correlation of those two random variables? By the formula of integration minus infinity to infinity x1 x2. So expectation of any function is, you write down that function into the density function. So what is the density function of these two random variables? Nothing but the joint density function, and it is given by f(x1, x2) of x1 comma x2 into dx1 dx2. So this is called as what? The correlation between these two random variables x1 and x2. Now the same concept we are applying to the random process also. So what is the random process? That has been represented by the variable x of t, or else it is also called as x of s comma t. So it is a function of both the sample space elements as well as the time variable. So this is called as what? Random process. Now we have seen the correlation between two random variables. Now how do you apply the same concept of correlation to the random process? So when you have seen the definition of the random process, we have observed three conditions. The first condition is when the time is constant in the random process. If t is constant and s is varying. So s is variable and t is constant. Now in the random process, if this variable t is constant, then it is a function of only the sample space elements, then it is called as what? Random variable. So this is called as what? Random variable. And second case you have taken, if s is constant. And second case, what you have taken? If the sample space elements or the outcome of the experiments are constant, then the random process will not vary with respect to s. It will vary with respect to only the variable t. So here t is variable. Then it is a function of only time. Now third case we have observed, both the time as well as the outcome of the experiments are constant. It means the random process is not varying with respect to change in the outcomes of the experiment, as well as it is not varying with respect to the variable t. Then you'll get the random process is a constant value only. Since both are constant, this value is not varying with any quantity. Therefore, is a random process is becoming what? A constant value. So we have observed three cases from the random process. When the time is constant in the random process, then the random process is a function of only the sample space elements. It is not varying with respect to t because it is constant here. So it is varying only with respect to the s. Then random process becomes what? Random variable. So we can define the random variables and the random process by which parameter? By keeping the time as constant. Now applying the same concept of correlation between two random variables to the random process also. For that, what I have to do? I have to define two random variables and the random process x of t. Now, what I am doing is, I am taking a random process x of t. So, what is this? This is a random process. Now, on this random process, I am defining two random variables. What are the two random variables? X1 and x2. So, how we are getting the random variable x1? By keeping the random process at t equals to t1 at a constant value, then we are going to obtain a random variable x1. And similarly, how we are getting the random variable x2? By keeping the time t equals to t2 in the random process, we are going to obtain the random variable x2. So, you are defining two random variables x1 and x2 on this particular random process x of t. By keeping, how we are getting the random variable x1? By keeping the time t equals to t1. And how we are getting the random variable x2? By keeping the time in the random process at t equals to t2, we are getting the random variable x2. So, you are defining two random variables in the random process. Now, you have the two random variables. Now, the correlation between these two random variables are nothing but what? Measuring the similarity between these two random variables which are defined. Where these two random variables are defined? These two random variables are defined on the random process x of t. It is called as what? Autocorrelation. Why the name auto? Because on the same random process, I am defining both the random variables. That's why the name is autocorrelation. Now, what is autocorrelation between these two random variables which are defined in the random process x of t? How do you represent by Rxx of t1, t2? In the previous case, if x1 and x2 are two random variables, then how do you represent the correlation of these two random variables Rx1, x2? Now, the same concept for the random process. How we are denoting the autocorrelation? Correlation nothing but what here? Represented by R is nothing but relation. So, R and here XX. Why it is XX? Because the first random variable X1 has been obtained by in the random process by keeping the time T equals to T1. And how we are getting the second random variable X2? By keeping the time T equals to T2 in the random process X of T, we are getting the second random variable X2. That's why the denotation of the autocorrelation for a random process x of t is by R suffix xx. Because t1, t2, both at the time instance, both the random variables are defined in the same random process. That's why the notation is what here? Xx. So, R represents correlation, xx represents auto. So, Rxx of t1, t2 is equals to what? E of. So, previously, so, for two random variables, what is the autocorrelation we have defined? The expectation of x1 into x2. Now, so what is x1? How are we getting the random variable x1? By keeping the time t equals to t1 in the random process x of t, we are getting the random variable x1. And similarly, how are we getting the random variable x2? By keeping the time t equals to t2 in the random process x of t, we are getting a random variable x2. So, therefore, the autocorrelation of the random process is given by Rxs of t1, t2 is equals to expectation of x of t1 into x of t2, that equals to what? E of x1 into E of x2. Sorry, E of x1 into x2. Here E represents what? Statistical average, and it is also called as what? Expectation. Now, in case of a continuous random process, then how do you write down the formula for the expectation? So, what is E of x1 into x2? So, previously, what is the formula expectation of x1 into x2? Since you're having two random variables, you have to take the double integration. And it is a joint density function. Now, you apply the same concept to the random process also. So, now, what is Rxs of t1, t2 is equals to? So, you're measuring the similarity between two random variables. So, that's why you have to take what? Double integration. So, why integration? I am considering that it is a continuous random process. So, therefore, integration minus infinity, integration minus infinity. So, what is E of x1 into x2? Nothing but x1 into x2. The expectation of any function is what? That function. So, x1 into x2. Into here, what you have written for two random variables x1, x2, I have written joint density function fx1, x2 of x1, comma x2. And similarly, how we are getting these two random variables in the random process x of t? By keeping the time t equals to t1, I am getting the random variable x1. And by keeping the time t2 in the random process x of t, I am getting the random variable x2. That's why, how do you represent the, it is a second order density function, nothing but fx of x1 comma x2. And how we get the x1 at t equals to t1. And how we are getting the random variable x2? By keeping the time t equals to t2. So, fx of x1 comma x2 colon t1 comma t2 into dx1 dx2. Here also what you having? Into dx1 dx2. So, here I have given x1 x2 for two random variables. In case of random process, these two random variables are defined the same random process, the representation by x only. So, that you can calculate the autocorrelation of two random variables which are defined in a random process x of t by using this formula. In case of discrete random process, in place of integration, you will get the summation sigma. Now, what is autocorrelation of two random variables? X of t1, x of t2, which are defined in a random process x of t, is given by Rx of t1 comma t2 is equals to what? E of x of t1 into x of t2. Now, let us consider this t1 is equals to t and t2 is equals to t plus tau. So, let us replace t1 by t and t2 by t plus tau. Now, what is here tau? Nothing but what? It is a difference between these two times. Now, what is t2 minus t1? That equals what is t2 now? T plus tau minus, and what is t1? Nothing but t. That equals to what? Tau. Now, what is tau here? It is a parameter delay or lagging time. It is a time difference between these two quantity and time quantities. So, replace this t1 by t and t2 by t plus tau. Then the autocorrelation function has been written as Rxs of, so t1 by t and t2 by t plus tau. So, Rxs of t comma t plus tau is equals to expectation of x of t1 in place of t1 t and in place of t2 by t plus tau. So, this is autocorrelation of two random variables which are defined in the random process x of t at the time instance t comma t plus tau. And this is autocorrelation of two random variables which are defined in the random process x of t at the time instance t1 and t2. Now, if we assume that the random process is a stationary, second order stationary random process. So, for stationary random process, what is the condition? For stationary random process, the joint density function should not vary with respect to time. If it is not varying with respect to time, then the autocorrelation function is also not varying with respect to time. Therefore, the autocorrelation function is a function of only tau. In previously, the normal random process x of t, it is a function of both the variable t as well as the tau. Now, in case of stationary random process, it should not vary with time. Therefore, it is a function of only tau. What is tau here? The time difference between those two intervals. So, for a second order stationary random process, what is Rx of t comma t plus tau? Nothing but Rx of tau. So, it is a function of only tau and is a function of both t and tau. That is the difference between the random process x of t and the stationary random process x of t. Let us see the properties of autocorrelation function. Now, what is autocorrelation function of a random process x of t? So, Rx of t comma t plus tau is equals to what? Expectation of x of t into x of t plus tau. So, if the case of stationary random process, so it is a function of only tau. So, you can write this Rx of t comma t plus tau by Rx of tau. So, what is the first property states that mod of Rx of tau less than or equals to Rxs of 0. So, what do you mean by Rx of 0? Nothing but it is autocorrelation function at the origin. Now, what is this property states that the autocorrelation function is having the maximum value at the origin. And the second property is states that the autocorrelation function is a symmetric function or an even function. And third property states that the autocorrelation function at the origin gives the mean, is nothing but mean, mean square of the random process. And the fourth property states that if the random process x of t is stationary and ergodic and it has no periodic components, then we can write down as limit mod tau tends to infinity rx of tau is equals to x bar square. And the fifth property states that if a random process x of t is stationary and is a periodic components, then you can say that its autocorrelation function is also periodic in the same period of the random process x of t itself. So these are the five properties of autocorrelation. And let us prove each and every property. What is the first property? Mod of rx of tau less than or equals to rx of 0. So what is the first property states that here? Rxs of mod of Rxs of tau, it is autocorrelation function, is always less than or equals to Rxs of 0. Now, so what is the autocorrelation function? Rx of tau is the autocorrelation function and Rx of 0 is a correlation function at the origin. So let us prove this property. So in order to prove this, first consider expectation of x of t plus tau plus or minus x of t whole square. So what is this value? Expectation nothing but what? Mean. And square nothing but what? Mean square of the function. Which function? X of t plus tau plus or minus x of t. And if you calculate the mean square value of any function, it is always a positive value only. Therefore, this is always greater than or equals to 0. Now, that equals to expectation of, this is like a plus or minus b whole square. So, what is a plus or minus b whole square formula? That equals to a square plus b square plus or minus 2ab. Now in place of a, I'm having x of t plus tau. And in place of b, I'm having x of t. Then you can write down as your x square of t plus tau, nothing but a square plus b square. In place of b, what you have here? X of t. So b square nothing but what? X square of t plus or minus 2 into a into b. What is a here? X of t plus tau into b, nothing but x of t. So it is greater than or equals to 0. So that equals to, how can I write u of x1 plus x2 plus x3 as u of x1 plus u of x2 plus u of x3? So how can I write u of x1 plus x2 plus x3 is equals to what? U of x1 plus u of x2 plus u of x3. So in place of x1, here I'm having x square of t plus tau. In place of x2, I'm having x square of t. In place of x3, I'm having 2x of t plus tau into x of t. Then how can I write down this equation as e of x square of t plus tau plus e of x square of t plus or minus 2. So 2 is a constant. I can bring it outside. Then e of x of t plus tau into x of t greater than or equals to 0. Now, what is e of x square of t and what is e of x square of t plus tau? So, what is rx of tau? We know the formula for rx of tau. So let us say this is equation 1. So, what is rx of tau? Nothing but e of expectation of x of t into x of t plus tau. Now, for tau equals to 0. So then what you are getting here? Rx of 0 is equals to what? E of x of t into x of t, because tau equals to 0. So t plus 0 nothing but t only. That equals to what? E of x square of t. Therefore, what is Rx of 0 is nothing but E of x square of t. And similarly, replace t by t plus tau, then what can you obtain? X square of t plus tau is equals to what? Again, Rx of 0 only. So, replace this t by t plus tau. So, here it is not a function of t or tau. It is not a function of t. for any value of t, what is e of x square of t? Nothing but rx of 0. So replace this t by t plus tau. Then what is e of x square of t plus tau is also again rx of 0. Now substitute this in the equation 1. Then what is u of x of t plus tau into x of t? That is nothing but what? Rx of tau. So substitute this rx of tau and u of x square of t and u of x square of t plus tau in the equation 1. Then you can obtain rx of 0 plus what you are having here. Equation 1 is e of x square of t plus tau. So what is e of x square of t plus tau? Rx of 0. Plus what is e of x square of t? Rx of 0. And what is this? Nothing but rx of tau. So you can write down this as rx of 0 plus or minus 2 into rx of tau. So it is what? Greater than or equals to 0. Now that equals to rx of 0 plus rx of 0 becomes what? 2 rx of 0 plus or minus 2 into rx of tau greater than or equals to 0. So that implies 2 into rx of plus or minus 2 into rx of tau is greater than or equals to. So bring this 2 into rx of 0 to the RHS side. Then what can you obtain here? Minus 2 into rx of 0. So this 2 will be get cancelled. After that, multiply with minus on both sides. So multiply with minus on both sides. Then what is the expression you are going to get? So minus or plus rx of tau. So when you multiply with minus, greater than becomes what? Less than. So greater than equals to becomes what? Less than equals to rx of 0. So I can write minus or plus as what? Modulus. Therefore, mod of rx of tau is always less than or equals to rx of 0. So this is the first property of the autocorrelation function. Therefore, what is the first property of the autocorrelation function states that? It states that the autocorrelation function is maximum at the origin. And what is the second property of the autocorrelation function we have seen? The second property states that rx of minus tau is equals to rx of tau. Let us prove this property. The second property of the autocorrelation function is rx of minus tau is equals to rx of tau. So what is this property states that? This property is called as what? Even R symmetric property. So that is this property. The property statement is what? Even R symmetric property. Now what is the statement of this property? What can you say that? The autocorrelation function is an even function of tau. R, the autocorrelation function is symmetric about the origin. That is a symmetric or even property of the autocorrelation function. Now let us prove this property. So first, what is autocorrelation function rx of tau formula? In all the cases, we are considering that the random process x of t is stationary. That's why instead of writing rx of t comma t plus tau, I'm writing only rx of tau. It is a function of only tau. It will not depend upon t in case of a stationary random process x of t. Now, what is rx of tau is equals to expectation of x of t into x of t plus tau. Now, replace tau by minus tau in the above equation. Then what can you obtain here? Rx of minus tau is equals to e of x of t into x of t minus tau. So replace tau by what? Minus tau. Now let t minus tau equals to some variable p. Let t minus tau is equals to p. That implies what is t is equals to p plus tau. What is t is equals to? Bring this minus tau to the RHS side. Then what is t equals to p plus tau? Then what do you get here? E of x of t. What is t here? P plus tau into x of t minus tau. What is t minus tau? Is nothing but p. that is nothing but what? Rx of minus tau. Therefore, what is Rx of minus tau we got? The previous slide. E of x of p into x of p, what do you got? X of p plus tau into x of p. So, x of p plus tau into x of p. Now, replace the variable p by t. Then what can you write here? Rx of minus tau is equals to expectation of x of t plus tau into x of t. Now, what is this equation? This is nothing but what? The autocorrelation function of the random process x of t only. That is nothing but what? Rx of tau. So, this is RHS and this is nothing but what? LHS. It means Rx of minus tau is equal to what? Rx of tau. So, the second property states that the autocorrelation function is an even function of tau. Even function is nothing but what? For example, so this is example of what? Even function. So, let us say this is t and this is tau. Let us say this is Rx of tau example. Then, so here what is Rx of tau is nothing but what here? Rx of minus tau only. That's why it is called as what? Even function or symmetric function. And the third property of the autocorrelation function given as Rx of 0 is equal to U of x square of t. This all you have done here. So, what is Rx of 0? That is nothing but what? E of x square of t. That is the third property of the autocorrelation function. So, what is the third property? Rx of 0 is equals to E of x square of t. What does it mean? The autocorrelation function at the origin gives the mean. Here, E is nothing but what? Mean. The different names for E are, this is also called as what? Expectation. Or, so it is also called as what? Statistical average. Statistical average. These are the different names you are having for the expectation. So it is all called as what? Mean or expectation, or is also called as the statistical average, or simply it is called as what? Average also. So what is this? The mean square. Square nothing but what? Yes, square in the random process. Mean square of the random process x of t. Here, what is x of t? That is nothing but what? Random process. So, the autocorrelation function at the origin, or is nothing but what? Tau equals to 0. Is equals to what? The mean square of the random process x of t. Now, how do you prove this property? This already have done. So, what is autocorrelation function? Rx of tau is equals to E of x of t into x of t plus tau. Now, substitute tau equals to 0. Then, what can you obtain? Rx of 0 is equals to what? E of x of t into x of t plus 0. Nothing but what? X of t. That is equals to what? E of x square of t. So, this is a third property of the autocorrelation function. And the, what is the fourth property states that if the random process x of t is stationary, ergodic and it has no periodic components, then limit mod tau tends to infinity Rx of tau is equals to what? X bar square. Here what is x bar? Nothing but the mean of the random process x of t. So, here what is the fourth property of the autocorrelation function states that the fourth property states that if the random process x of t is stationary, what is the first condition they are given? Stationary. Then what they are given that? It is ergodic. So, the random process x of t here it is stationary. Second point they are given is it is ergodic and then they are given that it has no periodic components. It has no periodic components. So, these are the things they have given. The random process x of t is stationary, ergodic and has no periodic components. Then, limit mod tau tends to infinity Rx of tau. So, the fourth property of autocorrelation function states that if the random process x of t is stationary, ergodic, no periodic components. Then limit mod tau tends to infinity rx of tau is equals to what? X bar square. Now we have to prove this property. So what they have given, the random process x of t stationary. The first condition they have given, the random process x of t is stationary. So if it is stationary, then what is the mean of the random process? For a stationary random process, it is constant. The mean of the random process is what? Constant. So it is constant for all values of t, whatever the value of t, but the mean of the random process is always constant, that is equals to what? X bar. And next, what they are given, that it is ergodic random process. So what do you mean by ergodic random process? So for ergodic random process, the statistical average, the statistical average of the random process is equals to what? The time average of the random process. Nothing but the x of t is ergodic. And third condition they have given, it is no periodic components. But the third condition they have given, it is no periodic components. So they have given the third condition is no periodic components. So what does it mean? Your x of t, and what is x of t plus tau? It is a delayed or advanced version of the random process x of t only. So what is x of t? It is a random process. Then what is x of t plus tau? It is a delayed or advanced version of the random process only. So they have given that it has no periodic components, and as tau tends to infinity, then these two signal, these two random process, nothing but x of t and its delayed or advanced shifted version of the random process has, are uncorrelated. As tau tends to infinity, then what is x of t and x of t plus tau are uncorrelated. So what do we mean by uncorrelated? Correlation nothing but measuring the similarity. And what is uncorrelation? There is no similarity between x of t and x of t plus tau. When it has no periodic components and as tau tends to infinity, then there is no correlation between this x of t and x of t plus tau. Now, if they don't have a similarity between the two random, the random process x of t and its shifted random process x of t, then what is the condition? Then what is u of x of t into x of t plus tau? If there is no correlation, then what is e of xy is equals to what? E of x into e of y. Similarly, what is e of x of t and x of t plus tau? You can write it as e of x of t into e of x of t plus tau. Now, what is e of x of t? Previously, we have assumed that the random process x of t is stationary. If it is stationary, then what is e of x of t is equals to x bar. Whatever the value of t, t may be t1, t2, or it may be t plus tau or t plus 10, whatever the value of t, but the mean is constant. Therefore, e of x of t is x bar, and similarly, whatever the value of t, but the mean is constant, nothing but x bar. That equals to what? X bar square. So therefore, limit mod tau tends to infinity. So mod tau tends to infinity. And what do you call as e of x of t and x of t plus tau? This is called as what? The autocorrelation function. So RxS of tau is equals to what? X bar square. So what is the fourth property states that if a random process X of t is stationary, ergodic, and have no periodic components, then as tau tends to infinity, the autocorrelation function value gives the square of the mean of the random process. So if the random process x of t is stationary, the mean is constant, as well as the autocorrelation function is a function of only tau only. It's a function of only tau. Then as tau tends to infinity and there are no periodic components. So if they give periodic components and as tau tends to infinity also, they will have a similarity between x of t and x of t plus tau. But they have given the condition that these two, the random process x of t has no periodic components, nothing but is aperiodic. Periodic is nothing but what? Where the same, the signal repeats after regular intervals of time. It is called as what? Periodic signal. Okay, so they have given that it is not a periodic, it is not repeating at regular intervals of time. And also they have given that tau tends to infinity. If this deal, if the shifting time is infinity, then there is no relation between these two, x of t and x of t plus tau. Then these two are said to be what? Uncorrelated. If they are uncorrelated, then what is e of xy equals e of x into e of y? Similarly, what is e of x of t and x of t plus tau is equals to e of x of t into x of t plus tau. Then equals to what is e of x of t, x bar, and e of x of t plus tau is x bar, because it is a stationary random process. So therefore, this is a fourth property of the autocorrelation function. And what is the fifth property states that here? The fifth property states that if the random process x of t has a periodic component and it is a stationary random process, then its autocorrelation function is also periodic with the same period of the random process x of t only. That is the fifth property of the random process x of t. So what is the fifth property states that if the random process x of t, let us say this is periodic with a period t. Let us consider the random process x of t is periodic the period of t. Then its autocorrelation function is also periodic with the same period t only. That is nothing but what? So periodic nothing but what is the condition for periodic? If x of t equals to x of t plus or minus t, it is nothing but what? Periodic random process. If it is periodic, what they have given that? The autocorrelation function is also periodic with the same period only. That is nothing but what? Rx of tau plus or minus t. So this is a fifth property of the autocorrelation function. Now let us see some problems on this autocorrelation function. So what is the given problem? Given the autocorrelation function for a stationary ergodic process with no periodic components is Rx of tau is equals to 25 plus 4 by 1 plus 6 tau square. Find the mean and variance of the random process x of t. So in the given problem, they have given Rx of tau is equals to what? 25 plus 4 by 1 plus 6 tau square. So what is the given data? So given that the autocorrelation function of the random process has 25 plus 4 by 1 plus 6 tau square. And what they have given that it is stationary. And is ergodic process and it has no periodic components. It has no periodic components. It means you have to use the fourth property of autocorrelation function. What is the fourth property of the autocorrelation function? If the random process is stationary, ergodic and have no periodic components, then limit mod tau tends to infinity. Rx of tau is equals to what? X bar square. Now, apply tau tends to infinity here. Then what can you obtain? So limit tau tends to infinity 25 plus 4 by 1 plus 6 tau square is equals to what? X bar square. So now substitute tau equals infinity here. Then what can you obtain here? So 25 plus 4 by 1 plus infinity square equals to x bar square. Then what is x bar square equals to 25? Then what is the mean of the random process is equals to plus or minus 5. Therefore, you have calculated the mean of the random process. Next, what you have to calculate? You have to calculate the variance of the random process x of t. So what is the variance of the random process? For example, if I take the random variable x. So what is the variance of the random variable x? E of x square minus x bar square. And similarly, what is the variance of the random process x of t here? E of x of t whole square minus x bar square. So you have to calculate e of x square of t. So what is e of x square of t? So you have to use the third property of autocorrelation function. What is this property states that? The autocorrelation function at the origin is equal to what? The mean square of the random process. Now substitute tau equals to 0 in rx of tau. Then what can you obtain? E of x square of t is equal to substitute tau equals to 0. Then what can you obtain? 25 plus 4 by 1 plus 0. Nothing but 25 plus 4. That equals to what? 29. Then what is the variance of the random process? e of x square of t minus x bar square. What is e of x square of t got? 29 minus x bar square means plus or minus 5 square. That equals to what? The variance is 4. So like that you can solve the problems on the autocorrelation function by using the properties of the autocorrelation function. And one more problem is, consider a random process x of t equals to a cos omega t, where omega is a constant and a is a random variable. So random process is a function of what? Both random variable as well as the time. So in this, omega is constant and a is a random variable. And what type of random variable they have given? It is uniform random variable. And what is interval? They have given 0, 1. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate the autocorrelation function of the random process x of t. So what is the autocorrelation function of the random process x of t? Rx of t, t plus tau. Since they have not given it is stationary, I'm writing Rx of t, t plus. It is depending upon both t and tau. Equals to what? E of x of t into x of t plus tau. So that equals to E of, what is x of t? A into cos omega t. Then what is x of t plus tau? Replace here t by t plus tau. Then what can write here? A into cos omega of t plus tau. That equals to, in this, E of a square into what here? Cos omega t into cos omega of t plus tau. So in this, which is a random variable are given? Omega is a constant. A is a random variable. So always the expectation will collect with respect to the random variable. So remaining terms are constant. Bring them outside. Then you can write it as cos omega t into cos omega of t plus tau into E of a square. Now you have to calculate E of a square. So what is the expectation of any function? For example, if you want to calculate the expectation of x square, then what is the expectation of x square formula? Integration minus infinity x square into fx of x dx. Now in place of x, you're having a. Then what is expectation of a square? Nothing but integration minus infinity a square into f a of a da. So this is the density function of the random variable a, and this is the density function of the random variable x. Now they have not given the density function, but they have given that a is a uniform random variable. So if it is a uniform random variable, what is density function? F a of a is equals to what? 1 by b minus a. And what is the interval they have given? 0 comma 1. For uniform random variable, what is the density function? Fx of x is equals to what? 1 by b minus a when x is a to b and 0 otherwise. So for what interval? A comma b. So in place of a comma b, I'm have here 0 comma 1. In place of x, I'm have here a. Then what can you append here? 1 by 1 minus 0 nothing but what? 1 by 1 minus 0 nothing but 1. For what values of a? When a is 0 to 1 and 0 otherwise. Now, so what is E of a square? E of a square equals to integration 0 to 1 a square into what is f e of 1? A is 1. So into what? Da. That equals to what? A cube by 3 and the limits are 0 to 1. That equals to what? 1 by 3. Therefore, what is E of a square value? 1 by 3. Now we substitute this in equation 1. Then what is autocorrelation function? Rxs of t comma t plus tau is equals to, so what is the function? Equation 1 is cos omega t into cos omega of t plus tau, and what is u of a square? 1 by 3. So cos omega t into cos omega of t plus tau into 1 by 3. So therefore, this is autocorrelation function of the random process. So in today's lecture, we have seen the definition of the autocorrelation function and properties of autocorrelation function. Autocorrelation function is nothing but measuring the similarity between two quantities. Auto means you have take the same only single random process x of t, and you have to measure the similarity between two random variables defined in the same random process x of t. And then we have seen the properties of the autocorrelation function, and we have proved all the properties of the autocorrelation function, as well as we have done some problems on autocorrelation function. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.